Is a compromise possible? Is it possible that while on the one hand, some children work at an early age because their families need their income, and they also get educated. There are arguments for and arguments against child labor that we've already seen. But when it comes to practically solving the problem, coming up with a policy which takes into consideration both advantages and disadvantages of child labor, is it possible that we come up with some solution which is a compromise solution? The two possibilities that are mentioned normally are that you eliminate child labor, as we have seen that there are laws that are there in place. And there is another policy which says that no, we don't need to eliminate child labor completely. We need to come to a compromise. We need to allow children to work if there is a need for their families, for them to be made to work. And they should also be educated formally, like all other children, in some manner. The arguments for the compromise policy are that when it is well known that child labor is not a complete curse without any advantages, why should not we go for the advantages that the children are able to get through child labor and make up for the disadvantages by teaching them the formal disciplines which all other children go through? Would it not be a big advantage for children who are working at an early age that on the one hand, they are reaping the benefits of working and getting experience and confidence that we've already talked about, and they're also getting the benefit of formal education as well? It would be probably getting the best of both worlds. Unko jo advantage hasil hogi, wo shayad un bachon ko hasil na ho sake ke jo sirf education ke liye jaate hain. So there are people who are strongly pleading the case for a compromise policy wherein children work and they also learn and get educated. There are arguments against compromise policy. There are people who say that there should be one uniform policy for all children of a society. It is not a great idea that you divide a society right from the beginning into two groups, two categories, those who learn and work and those who get educated only. Inka kehna ye hai ke education or work ke natije mein jo aap advantages dekh rahe hain, wo advantages aap system of education mein incorporate kar dein. Why should the other children be deprived of those advantages? Children in no case should be put under the burden of working for the purpose of earning for their parents. If their parents are poor, it is no fault of theirs. The society should take care of the poverty of the parents who have to force their children to work. Unka kehna ye hai ki ye jo compromise policy hai, jisme ke aap baz bachon ko kaam bhi karwa rahe hain aur unko padha bhi rahe hain, ye to phir again it's going to create problems in the society and there are going to be two different categories of children. This point of view, which goes against a compromise policy, it says that we should have one policy for all children. And if there are advantages of early childhood work, let that advantage be incorporated in the education policy of a country so that all children get the advantage, the benefit of learning as well as working. And that is what everybody should get, because there are psychological disadvantages which those children would suffer from who work as well as get educated. So let us go for the best outcome, the best way out, which is to allow all children to get educated at the same level and to allow all of them to also work in a way that their education gets practical. It is practically useful for everybody.